हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम एचएल गुप्ता। आई एम गोइंग टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड इलस्ट्रेशन 40 ऑफ सीएमए इंटर फर्स्ट ग्रुप जॉइंट प्रोडक्ट एंड बाय प्रोडक्ट। ओके, प्लीज रीड द क्वेश्चन शेयर। प्लीज लुक एट हियर इलस्ट्रेशन 40। इन अ फैक्ट्री producing joint products of two varieties of the following data are given. Sales of product X and Y. This is the product X and Y sales is this 750,000. Direct material, direct labor, variable overhead 150% of this. Means variable overhead is 150% of the labor. You have to keep in your mind. Wherever labor, then variable overhead incurred, that is 150% of labor. Okay? Here it is calculated 150% of 110,000. This is 1.5 into 110,000. This is 1,05,000. This is 1,65,000. Fixed overhead, this is 2,00,000. The analysis of the sales revealed that the percentage of sales of product X is this. It means X the percentage is this. It means this is 66.6666%. This is the product sale of X, and product Y will be the 33.3333, like this. In this case, you have to calculate the sales of X. In this case, sales of X, X will be rupees 5,00,000, and Y will be rupees 2,50,000. How one X will be 25,00,000? Because of this 66.66666% of 750,000, that is the rupees 5,00,000, and that is 33.3333% of 750,000. This is the for X and this is for Y. Okay, 750,000, this will come 2,50,000. Okay, the sales revenue of this is, you have calculated. These are the expenditure incurred for X and Y. The management contemplated the process for the joint products so that they could be sold at a higher rate. Facilities for these available. The additional expenditure for the further process and the total sales anticipated for the higher selling prices are given below. Make recommendation presenting the effect of the proposal. In this question, it is asking to you, what is asking here? Look at it. In this case, this process is done. At this split up point, there are two products are made. One is a X, other is the Y. At this split up point, you are going to sell the product X rupees 5,00,000, and at this split up point you are going to sell the product, this is 2,50,000. You are going to further process. After further process, you are going to sell this rupees 6,00,000. This is given here rupees 6,00,000. And product Y you are going to sell rupees 3,00,000. Product Y you are going to sell rupees 3,00,000. And to get the sales, you need to expenditure these expenditure as well as variable overhead. These expenditure is incurred. Now it is asking to, this is 3,00,000. You are going to sell rupees 3,00,000. Now it is a question asking to you whether it is better decision to proceed further or not. That you need to calculate here. You have to evaluate here. In this case, we have to calculate additional sale, that is incremental sale. An incremental cost. Incremental sale is greater than incremental cost. In that case, further processing is better decision. If incremental sales is not greater than incremental cost, then further process is not better decisions. the in this case you need to calculate first sales. Okay, look at it. In this case, what you have to do here? Solution. Working note first. Calculation of sales revenue of product X at split up point. Two by three percentage of 7,50,000. That is 66.6666% of 7,50,000. That is ₹5,00,000. Working note second. Calculation of sales revenue of product B. Sales revenue of product X and Y. Sales revenue product Y, that is total sales minus sale of X. Total sales are 7,50,000. Sale of X is 5,00,000. This is ₹2,50,000. Calculation of incremental sale. Working note second. Calculation of incremental sale after further process. X here, this is the Y. Sales after further process. After further process. Look at here. What is the sales after further process? This is given. Sales after further processing, this is given ₹6,00,000 for X, ₹3,00,000 for Y. This is ₹6,00,000. This is ₹3,00,000. Sales at a split up point. ₹5,00,000. This is ₹2,50,000. Additional sales or incremental sale. Incremental sales ₹3,00,000. Calculation of profit due to additional sale. Calculation of profit on incremental sales. Calculation of profit on incremental sale. Here product X Y incremental sales ₹1,00,000. ₹50,000 here. less further processing cost. Further processing cost. These costs are given here. Look at here. Additional material 50,000, 50,000. Additional direct labor 20,000. This is a 20,000. This is a 8,000. Additional material. Additional raw material. This is the 50,000. This is your 20,000. Additional direct labor. This is 20,000. This is 8,000. Additional variable overhead. 150% of direct labor, then 20,000 is here. One is 20,000, 1.5, in other 8,000 into 1.5, this is the 30,000, this is your 12,000. 30,000, this is your 12,000. Now what will be the net incremental profit? Incremental profit, this is a zero. In this case, this is the 10,000. It means there is a no use of further processing a product X. In further processing product X, no additional benefit you are going to receive. But in the case of Y, you have an additional profit of rupees 10,000. Hence, product X should be sold at a splitter point and product Y should be further processed. Okay. From above calculation, it is observed that product X should be sold at a split off point and product Y should be further processed. Further process, because X does not have any profit, additional profit, but Y has a profit of rupees 10,000. Okay, thank you class. Please like, subscribe and share my video. Okay, thank you class.